The lunch hour in Times Square, New York turned into a nightmare for thousands of people in the immediate area when a man in a maroon Honda plowed into a crowd. He killed an 18-year-old woman and injured 22 more in the process, in what's been reported as a drunk driving accident. However, photos are starting to emerge now of people who watched it happen and snapped shots of the killer, particularly with what he did after getting out of the car, that changes everything about what the mainstream media telling us. The immediate reaction when word first broke that 26-year-old Richard Rojas had rammed his car into a group of people was that this was the modus operandi of Islamic terrorists. Spectators were quick to assume that because of this, the attack was an act of terrorism, until mainstream media rapidly squelched that idea by insisting that this man was a drunk driver considering two previous DWI charges. While it does appear that Rojas was intoxicated and authorities have confirmed that he's a resident of the Bronx, there are a series of pictures that shows something else nobody is talking about but needs to. While much of the media has been filled with picture of Rojas' car heaved up on some barrier posts and hard-to-see images of him being arrested, this new set of very vivid pictures show what he did right after killing the young woman identified as Alyssa Velsman. The 18-year-old was a tourist from Michigan who was in the Big Apple on vacation with her family, according to the Daily Mail. Rojas jumps out of his car and rather than acting stunned at the accident he just caused, with victims' bodies all around him, he launched into a seemingly drug-induced lunacy, jumping around in the street and acting like a crazed person. Rojas reportedly led police on a foot chase for 3 blocks before they were able to detain and arrest the psychopath. Witnesses who spoke to the Daily Mail described a terrifying scene that the mainstream media isn't reporting. "He's just mowing down people," A.S.A. Lowe, who was standing outside a store when he heard screaming, explained to the news outlet. "He didn't stop. He just kept going. After the car struck a barricade and stopped, the driver climbed out of his vehicle," Lowe said. "He just started running until people tackled him down. Citizens just reacted," she added. Rojas reportedly led police on a foot chase for 3 blocks before they were able to detain and arrest the psychopath. The Daily Mail reports, a crazed Rojas had allegedly attempted to flee police immediately after the crash and was pictured running across the road with his arms flailing. Police said Rojas got into a fist fight with an officer as they struggled to arrest him, before he was eventually tackled to the ground and bundled into a squad car. Rojas, a U.S. military veteran, was taken to a testing facility where he will be screened for drug use, according to police. Rojas later admitted that he had smoked marijuana before the attack, seemingly as to blame his lethal actions on his use of it. "His actions certainly suggest more was at play here than just marijuana, which nobody should be driving under the influence of, but the psychosis is suffered on the street looks like the result of something else, or a combination of things. While there doesn't appear to be a terrorism motive behind his actions, it's important to note that it's rather common for terrorists to use drugs in the moments before committing jihad. We may never know for sure if that had any part in Rojas choosing to plow pedestrians over, but the similarities are eerie and the media now has a new excuse to use for a motive in future attacks. Since the word terrorism is avoided like the plague by the left in any instance like this, they can now verbally assume off the bat that anything that resembles this in the future was simply driving while intoxicated. Some today are even going as far as to call this an accident and nothing more than that, but I bet the victim's family feel differently. This was a horrific tragedy caused by a man, who by his own choosing partook in a substance, S, that impaired his ability to operate a vehicle. He then entered into one of the busiest parts of the city at the most congested time of day and drove into a crowd of people. That wasn't an accident, it was a criminal act for why 23 people paid the price for, one fatally so.
Please do not forget to subscribe and like and comment because we want to hear your voice and thank you for watching.